episode of Dice Vice.
All right. So, while you were unconscious and all this transpired, you going and getting all that, it's been a short rest, essentially, so you can spend hit dice if you would like to no longer be unconscious.
Do I do that from the negatives or from a zero?
From a zero. If you have any hit dice to spend.
I have three to spend.
I mean, they are bringing you down to me, so...
And we will go with that they have stabilized you. And over this amount of time, you can do the same if you would like.
Okay.
As well as they are kind of keeping you in holding, because... With the arrival of everybody, they are slightly confused and concerned as to what has been happening. So, what is your current health at, may I ask?
After spending all three of them,
14.
You have 14 health?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, considering I have a D10, I rolled an 8, 4, and a 2.
Yeah, that kind of sucks.
Yeah.
Isn't it like half?
That's when, by the way, not.
Gotcha.
So wait, were you going for 0?
Yeah.
And how about you? You have 5?
I have 5. I spent 1.
Alright, so both of you are conscious again.
Woo! I need another 12 points for 12 months.
I need another 14. So.
Actually, both of you guys are 14 points away from being full. And
12.
Say what?
12.
You're 12 away?
Yeah. I'm 14 health. I've got a max.
Oh, that's right. You've taken 12. He's taken 14. That's right. If I did it correctly. I'm just... Yeah. You've puzzled it. Maybe a little bit. So, with this, let's go ahead and we will jump back to up top where they will... come up to you and...
Oh, God!
Kind of... They have some staffs and things like that. They will go and... One of them will poke the... Wrong mouth. Will poke the body that's over by the campfire. And two of them will come over to you, seeing as how you made it further in. They're going to assume that you're the alive one.
Right.
And they're not trying to hide their movements or anything. They're making noise as they approach you. But they will kind of tap you on your boot.
I'm going to wake up with a snarl. Like, to my feet, weapon drawn.
You don't seem to be as injured as they think.
Dragon, common.
Common.
Who thinks?
I'm assuming your party members.
What do they look like?
Humanoid. One of them was... tiefling.
That's them. What'd they tell you?
That you guys ran in here to escape the Lady of Frost, who's kind of gone on a rampage. And...
Oh, good. The mold of the dice.
Nope. I don't know about any lady, but I know about a big fucking dragon.
That is the Lady of Frost.
Gotcha.
So they are downstairs. We are finding some food and waiting until the entrance is open so that way you all may leave if you'd like.
Did lead on.
Alright.
This stays out.
There is no need, but if you must. I ask that you sheathe it, but you don't have to, you know, give it to us or anything like that.
I'm going to carry it until I'm comfortable.
And both of them are going to walk off ahead.
Leave that one poor guy to deal with the other things that are out there?
Yeah. You know, okay. He's actually going to go and drag the bodies this way and chuck them into the pit of lava. Which you all can see from down below.
Does nobody believe in the splash radius here?
Well,
a pit of lava. How high up was that? 30 feet?
30 feet. But lava doesn't have the same consistency as water.
I'm gonna follow.
Going to follow?
Yeah.
All right.
Cautiously.
So, maintaining, like, that distance?
Yeah.
Okay.
Maintaining stabbing distance.
So.
Right.
They will...
Where is it?
It's under you.
Apparently, I have to do that once.
They're my favorite.
Be winking at.
Done with that map for the moment. Alright. So, they've led you to the entrance and you see the large stone door, probably about 4 feet across, and since it's open you can tell probably foot and a half thick, and a dragon carving on the front. Mouth closed, and large rubies or large sapphires.
I was like,
eyes.
Whoa, hey now. The eyes changed.
Big door.
Gotta pour some lava in the mouth now.
That's shiny. I want it.
They'll say, please follow me. We're continuing on. And at this point, one will lead you forward, and the other one will be behind you, escorting you through their area. And you can hear that there is quite a commotion and many people in this area.
We'll follow down, keeping one eye over my shoulder. Grip will tighten on my mace.
Alright. At this point, I assume that you guys have come inside as well. Alright.
Everybody's here!
You assume quite a bit.
Would you prefer to be somewhere else?
I just don't think I'd be standing that fucking close.
Mini whelps.
What, like 5 feet?
Mini whelps?
5 feet away from lava?
Yeah.
Need more dots?
Would you like to be further away?
I'll stand next to the people on this one.
Alright. Anybody else want to change their position? I don't necessarily see anything.
Yeah, I want the wall to my back.
So you would come in and step like there.
Yeah.
No.
For ample reason. He knows what we've done. He doesn't know the whole story yet.
Go lay down.
Up. Pixie. Up. Hey. Get up here. Lay down.
Daddy, I want to be on TV.
So, now that everybody is here...
Am I about to fill up in the air, or am I
just
standing
up
now?
I can wake up
that,
and just
that's up
there
to you.
My butt is in the air.
Well, I don't think so.
Although, with these people, your butt may help us.
Just gash them out.
It's not at all what I had in mind.
Would you like to be awake, or...?
Yeah, I'm going to stand up. Hopefully, like, well, alright.
Are you the real assumption?
Please stand up. Please stand up.
Alright.
So you're just terrible.
But...
round of applause.
No. Alright. So the leader, who is outlined with a circle instead of not having a circle.
I was wondering what was going on there. It's like, is that one a stone one again?
That's the one that's too charmed.
He is slightly taller, probably about 4.5 feet tall. And his head, or his hood, is actually bat, revealing the head of a kobold.
Of a what?
Kobold. Kind of a reptilian dog head, and they have more scales, things like that.
So essentially, we've wound up on Endor in our roguish Chewbacca.
Do
I'd make the noise, but I can't.
Maybe a little bit.
I hope all of you on the internet understood that reference. If not, go educate yourself.
The force is not with you.
But he turns to each of you. We don't have many supplies, but what we do have, we are welcome, or more than willing to share with you.
Thank you.
Basic food, bread, a little bit of meat, water. About all that we live off of.
I'm in a nunnery.
Food's food.
A generous.
And this one on the edge will wander off and grab any food and things like that that's requested.
Not in the storage room?
Not in the storage room.
What was in the storage room, Pixie?
I don't know. I was more concerned about finding passage. I just noticed it was storage room.
You were so concerned about finding passage. What are you doing back in the main hall?
I don't know.
The Pixie got charmed. By the way, guy was like, well, me.
Okay. All right. Let's go.
Hey,
don't
man,
eat me. You're
back.
4 feet tall. I'm only a foot and a half tall.
You look to be feeling a little better.
You know, just needed a short nap.
A dirt nap.
You know, there's a pit of lava over there.
Found
a new home. Kind of.
All right.
He will come back.
Oh, Naz, you didn't.
Maybe.
That kobold will come back in bringing, you know, many loaves of bread, a bucket of water.
Y'all got kolaches?
What? Okay. Something that I don't know about, apparently.
You gotta learn about kolaches.
Okay.
You really do. Kolaches, man.
Am I the only one that doesn't know, or are you all too,
I don't
too, too busy with the dog?
Delicious bread and rolls filled with stuff.
She was hiding behind the curtain. It was really cute.
I don't know what those are. Okay, good. Not just me.
We'll give you some information after this wonderful episode.
Okay. So, the chieftain will tell several of the kobolds to go and work on clearing out the entrance. And see what they can do to, you know, hasten that. And
we'll thank them graciously again.
And three of them will wander off to go do that.
Could I help by using druidcraft?
And making kolaches?
Okay, what is a kolache again? I still don't know.
We'll tell you later.
Okay.
I'm just trying to figure out why she's using her druidcraft.
No,
to melt
the
ice.
You'd have to go and try.
I hate to tell you, your druidcraft hasn't exactly been helpful in the past. She crafts a candle this big. Holds it against the ice.
Fire.
She's been healing us with it.
No, she has not been using druidcraft to heal. She's been using heal to heal.
Okay, so the first thing I want to do is I would like to go ahead and give these guys some more health, just for good measure.
Okay, how would you like to do that?
Please hold. I'm not damaged exactly. Okay, I'm going to go ahead. Who has the least health?
There you go.
Okay, you have the least health.
I got 5 points.
So I'm going to go ahead and use Cure Wounds on you.
Okay.
I have to touch you, so I'm going to go.
You're already rubbing.
I'm touching your tail or whatever. You can get a number of hit points equal to 1d8 plus 4.
Okay, so you roll the 1d8 here.
D8 pickers.
It's the diamond.
Can I re-roll?
No.
5.
Plus 4. Or was that plus 4?
That was plus 4.
So it's literally the crit fails and went. Yes.
Next. No.
Oh, no, sorry, no. Me, John, me, Alex. There we go.
By the way, process of elimination, she's next.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody's got this part.
Are these guys related to dragons?
So did that take him back up to full health?
No, not at 10.
Give me a history check.
A history check?
Yep. 20 years ago.
Not one of my skills.
It is one of my skills.
Time for me to roll my one.
Right, but you're not thinking it.
16.
Oh, I'm sorry.
16.
Okay.
You assume that at some point in history, you don't know when, that dragons and kobolds had to have shared like some distant ancestor. But over the millennia, the kobolds are no longer, you know, able to fly. Obviously, they don't have wings.
They look like dogs.
They look much closer to dogs.
You know what I'm imagining? You know the end of Ghostbusters, the original? It's big dogs on the roof.
Okay. Yeah.
As old as puppies.
Somewhat. If you want a picture, there's a...
They stand up? Those don't look anything like dogs.
They're humanoid.
Humanoid.
They actually kind of look like a dodo bird in the face to me.
Alright.
But I'm not wearing glasses, so.
So,
next you just need a lizard with a ladder.
So that's an idea of what they look like, at least.
So he regained some health.
Yep.
Okay. That was an action, and then...
Well, we're not in combat, so if you wanted to just use actions for each of them, you're more than...
Well, my healing word's a bonus action anyways. So I'll do healing word on Naz.
Okay.
And it's 1d4.
I could probably use something more than that.
Well, we're not in combat, so she can literally just do that.
Yeah. We're not too concerned about it.
8. So you get 8 points back.
She's a die 8, and I get 5. Yeah, 5 points
actually. Four more!
Okay.
It's because you're dating your sister. She's got to find some way to get back to you.
Okay.
I already fell down the pit. Face first. What do you want?
So did Naz! But your butt fluttered. Hey, I went down there to save you, okay? Alright. Also, I'm going to... I would like to approach the head honcho dude and say I may have a spell that can help melting ice.
You are more than welcome to go use it.
Okay, I'll go flutter up with the other duties.
Would you like to fly up through the hole or go through the tunnel?
I'll take the hole.
All right.
I'd just like to state
tell me, Pixie, why did the healer leave the room again? When we're surrounded by people who don't really trust us as it is, but are still being polite for the time being.
Oh, wait a second. I know the answer to this one.
She hates us.
Yeah, I don't even fully deal with it.
All right.
So, you fly back up towards the top, and you see the three kobolds rushing up to the tunnel that has the ice plugging in.
They're rushing.
They were told to go get to work on it.
Okay.
So what would you like to do?
I'm going to go up and say, excuse me, I may have a spell that can help. Your leader said things, whatever.
Okay.
Whatever, you're going to tell him whatever?
No.
Have some diplomacy.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to use Druidcraft. I'm going to attempt to melt this ice with my cantrip. And I'm going to call upon the spirits of nature. And...
What did I do with
that? Actually, no.
Seriously.
I have lost my player tank.
There it is. I have to look up the specifics of Druidcraft.
Okay.
There's proper.
I mean, technically, there's for children, so there might be a reason it doesn't actually fit on your finger.
Yeah, that was a mistake. You fell through a hole, but I killed two hyenas, pissed on a tree, and made the whole mountain move, and then fell through a hole.
I right. actually killed the gargoyle. Huh?
Okay, so essentially, I can harness different sensory effects. So I can either light a fire, or I can.
Oh, now you killed the dragon.
Have.
Wait, now that I remember, I actually forgot.
Can I harness, would it work to harness warm wind or hot wind?
Like a hair dryer? Get a hair dryer?
I'll go ahead and give you the ability to make essentially a hair dryer.
Can it be a really big hair dryer?
It's a druidcraft. You're lucky you got electronics, okay?
It'll be about 6 inches around, which, if you think about it, that's a third of how tall you are. So it's relatively big for you.
I saw that in Dresden once.
Exactly.
I can't have anything better than that.
You do have something better than that.
I know I have flaming sphere.
Sphere.
Flaming
sphere.
All right.
I have a fire sphere.
But
I want
a
fire.
But
I want to make a hair dryer.
Exactly. It's using the correct spell for at the correct time.
Alright. I'm gonna tell everybody to step the fuck way back.
Oh, watch it. The pitch is getting up in it.
The kobolds will step back, look at you skeptically, going,
I can't hurt people with this.
Just remember how she's that big. So
step back! Push it up! Have a good night!
Okay, guys, you got fire! Flame on, bitches!
Thank you, John. I appreciate that.
I'm here for you.
Okay. So, my sphere is 5 feet in diameter.
Yes.
So, it is going to burn a decent hole through this fucker.
Yep.
That's a bigger
one. So, for her, you know, spare bomb.
It's true.
Now, technically, I'm supposed to focus it on a creature. Can we call the ice a creature?
Let me read this real quick. 5 foot diameter sphere of fire appears in an unoccupied space of your choice within range and lasts for the duration, which is up to 1 minute.
Okay, so we're good. But I need the door again. It's 70 feet. Okay, so...
No, it's 40.
Oh, it's 40 feet? Cool. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to step a little back because 60 feet is 40 feet. I'm going to stand about 20 feet from the ice because I don't want to hurt myself.
Okay.
And I'm going to cast Flaming Sphere on the ice.
Okay.
And I'm going to push it forward through the ice.
All right. It does go quite a ways through, and it does melt it. However, 40 feet of solid ice is a lot of ice. So it takes more than one casting. If you would like to do two of them back-to-back, I will say that you are able to go through the entire thing. If not,
okay.
Then you are able to get about halfway through.
Well,
you couldn't bring this up earlier when we were trying to get out.
Do you have enough casting spell?
It's an action.
We're not worried about action. We're worried about your spell slots.
Well,
I'm worried that I'm stuck with a fucking cult, is what I'm worried about. And she could have said something about us being able to get to the ice earlier.
So I'm against the wall with my mace up.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm standing next to Naz, now that I know he's back.
No, I can cast it again.
Okay.
Because I use I have four. Yeah.
I'm not gonna
I can use it again. No, we're good. Okay, so I'm going to cast it again.
Use Midget Moldus. Still haven't made.
I know.
All right, so you cast it again, and you have roughly about a 5 foot diameter tunnel leading out of the ice.
Cool.
And then you look through. She's just there, like.
Bitches!
Holds up a claw.
Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and flit back down the hole.
I saw this one moving once. No, she'll flirt.
Okay.
And I am going to go directly to the leader.
Okay.
And
wow,
say,
I
have cleared a core of ice. Me and my party appreciate your hospitality. And we will be on our way.
I'm glad to hear it. I'm glad that you were able to do that. So, thank you all. Please get out.
Gone.
Pixie for the win!
My guy's like, if nobody minds, I'm going to take the stairs instead.
Good idea.
Yeah. Walks off with 19 points for Malix.
As you guys walk out of... Yeah, we ended up getting kicked out, by the way. As you all walk out... It's not what it's supposed to look like, but sure.
You just, like, devoured
this
that
one?
No, because that one was spelled wrong, so we moved over to Hang On, She's Broke.
Alright, so we're getting there. But as you guys are walking out of the chamber, through the hallway that Naz is closest to, because I'm assuming that he wouldn't want to cross the entire room with
no
10 or 12.
Yeah, we're just going to back out that door next to us.
Mm-hmm. There will be a...
If you got my back, I'll take one.
There will be a kobold that rushes out of the small area that was off to the right that you went down and found another door.
Those storms.
He'll rush out and go, something weird is happening in here.
I knew you were full of shit. Wait, who is he talking
just,
to? Or is he just talking to
excuse me,
room?
I have to get by to talk to my leader.
Hey, bud.
What's going on? Is there anything we can help with?
You're more than welcome to go and look in the kitchen.
In the kitchen?
That's what's in that room.
The storage room was a kitchen?
No, the room he
no
led you to was a kitchen. He took you to dinner.
No, something weird is happening in the kitchen.
Fairies are delectable. All
right.
Fairies upstairs.
No,
I came down.
The fairies with you guys again.
Yeah, I came down to get you all.
But you're not in the kitchen.
I don't know where I am.
Okay, we're back.
Apparently in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. Okay, there, she's back.
So where is this kitchen?
The kitchen is down this hallway to the right.
The other door.
Yeah. So this guy came rushing out to right there.
I really feel like we had enough sandwich for one day.
Yeah, let's get the fuck out of here. Come on, dragon.
And I'm muttering myself. I'm just beeline towards the exit.
Alright, so you all are going to...
We're booking it out
continue
before
leaving.
They catch
They're
us.
Like, shit's going down! We're like, bye!
Alright. So, as you guys are continuing on, we don't really have a need for the map anymore. If you guys are just leaving.
Going
oh, no.
up the tuba, French horn, foot.
I thought he was going to be like, and the door shuts for you.
What was your logic? Oh yeah, I am not a cook.
So?
No professional training.
You're still avoiding lawsuits, apparently.
Yep.
Okay. So you all continue back up. You make it to the chamber above.
Make it out the cave?
Just so everybody knows, if you're over 5 foot, you're going to have to crawl.
Oh, yeah, no, I thought about that. You're like, 5 foot hole, and I was like, shit.
Just
but
bend
you know,
over.
You're a lizard man. stick your head out the cave. Clear!
Yeah, I don't think lightning melts ice as easy as fire is.
No, definitely not.
Yeah, exactly.
So... With that, you guys make it out of the gate.
Oh,
it feels like we were in there forever.
Well, then you should have stayed behind with the pixie and found out what was in the kitchen.
Do you guys
just tell us anyway?
Do you guys want to do that?
I don't want to go back.
No.
Well, no, if you guys don't want to have followed them directly out, you guys are more than welcome to investigate the kitchen.
Yeah, no,
I
want to
know what's in the kitchen. I don't want to go in the kitchen.
No, I don't
want to. You got to go in the kitchen if you want to know what's going on in the kitchen.
No,
apparently the kitchen is not important.
No, the kitchen is not that important.
You have to know these things yourself and make your own decisions.
No, I'm leaving.
You don't know.
This will haunt me.
It will if you don't.
Do you need to go to the kitchen?
No!
See,
okay.
I can live with not knowing what's in the kitchen.
I'm
not being paid to go to the kitchen.
We've been through enough. We're going to make it back to town now. Thank you.
Alright, I vote we take a short rest so we can all regain all of our health.
Excuse me, I haven't been hitting forever.
You all have made it out of the cave. What would you all like to do?
Look around, listen, see if Mama is still out there.
Give me a perception check.
I feel like we should all try and perceive.
Right?
Go for this block view.
Okay, I'm going to perceive too, because I don't particularly want to.
8+3, 11.
You don't hear or see any sign that she is near.
Think we're okay.
Is that your one?
I got two. I got a 14.
None of you see or hear anything that would signal that she's around.
All right.
So we head back to town?
Here's the plan, guys. We're going back to town. And girls.
Oh, no. That's not it. Go on, mister. I fucked up.
All right. So we're going to go back to town. We see anything that can make us more money, no matter how much you might want to, you're leaving it alone.
Did you?
So fuck.
Go look in a mirror.
Let's go.
Let's go get paid.
Exactly it.
All right.
May I recommend?
Nobody.
Not me? I didn't do it?
Yeah, it's like you didn't kill the dragon.
Excuse me, whose deception worked and didn't get us killed?
Men
who kept falling into stuff and killing shit just to fuck us over.
May I recommend that
we
attempt to stay under some cover just in case, Mama?
How are we going to stay under cover? There's a big open space we have to go to just get into town.
Yeah.
Well, as much as possible. So on the way to town, you know, walk along the path but stay under the trees.
Oh, there's no walking. I'm doing this for a nice brisk jog.
Who's jogging? I'm jogging.
Alright!
Keep up! And I'm gonna take off.
Alright. It's still about 3 hours to get
That's totally fine. I can keep that pace.
Give me a
you can teleport.
Check.
Every time I get behind, it's like
37.
Okay, I'm back.
You're heavily, heavily winded at the end of it. Anybody else trying to keep that same pace?
No. I can keep that same pace.
You can?
It's my terrain. I can't keep that same pace. And if you're traveling with me for more than an hour, you don't get winded either.
It's not that you're not winded, it's that you don't get slowed by the terrain.
Perfect. It's good enough for me. I'm
that
flying.
Is a normal walk.
If I'm winded, that... No. It says traveling. It does not say anything about walking. It says traveling. I could be in a fucking bus. And I would not be slowed by terrain.
We have our rules lawyer.
What check is it?
Athletics. Constitution.
I'm flying. Do
or
I need a constitution check?
You can do athletics as well.
Okay. 25.
You're fine.
Did you just ask him so you could rub that in his face?
Pretty much.
I didn't get a lot.
I rolled a 20 and then my athletics is a 5.
20.
So. I rolled a 20 and I didn't tell him. I
got a 19.
In your athletics?
I used constitution.
The fairy's wings. The pixie's wings are winded.
I'm in trouble.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I rolled a 3.
Can
I ride her?
I was actually about to say when she starts like falling behind, I'll reach out, grab the pixie, and continue to jog.
Okay, cool, John. I had the exact same thought.
Cool.
There
somebody's carrying me.
You were.
It's all good.
You weigh like 5 pounds anyway.
Right. That's only once you tire out.
Okay.
Which is rather quickly.
Her fucking shoulders are cramping.
Well, you know, I saved everyone's ass. It was very tiring.
Yeah,
what? By going on a date with the guy downstairs?
Well, by curing these two dimwits and getting rid of the ice!
No, these two dimwits are the ones that got us into this trouble.
That's true.
If you didn't save them, I would have been fine.
What? So, you all have arrived. You all have arrived back at the end of town.
Let's do it.
And I feel great.
Is town still...
Who's up for round two?
Yeah.
Is town still there?
The town is still there.
Okay. Is it...
No, the lady obliterated it.
Is
it's
it
frozen.
Frosty? Is the snowman walking around over obliterated land?
Hey, everybody, where'd you go?
It's just Olaf hanging out.
I was only gone for a year. What?
So how long total have we been gone from town? Just out of curiosity.
You left for the tomb. It was 3 days there and 3 days back.
Oh,
so
my
six and a half days.
A little detour.
About a week.
Yeah.
Detour. Wow.
Yeah.
It's like a cheese wrapper. Yeah, it was like a cheese wrapper. All of a sudden, she was here.
Oh, that's it. Change the subject while we're talking about something else.
Sorry, I just had a dog on my feet. Yeah, I'm being whipped.
So what would you all like to do?
I'm gonna go get paid.
Yeah.
Gonna get paid, gonna go fucking relax.
Well, let's go get paid and rest.
So you guys go back to the guard captain.
Yep.
Let me find his name real quick. That I have them here.
Wasn't it like dude or something?
Hey dude.
Hey dude.
There we go.
I was close because I was thinking of a guy.
His secretary is Alex's face with the blue gun.
Right. Dolls up a little bit.
What's up, my dude?
So, you walk into City Hall. His door is currently closed.
Oh no.
We're gonna knock. We're gonna be polite first.
Okay, so you walk up to his door, knock.
Well, like, bang.
Bang.
I'm okay with that. As long as we don't just burst in.
Come on in.
Open the door.
Oh, no.
You wanted an amulet?
But when I saw Henry come in, I didn't think that I'd see you guys again.
Henry.
Henry, the guard that...
The guard that we
you.
Left to die?
I didn't know his name.
He
of course he had a name.
So,
well, we just never knew it.
Here's how this...
Asked,
you traveled with him for 5 days and you didn't bother to ask his name.
No. We knew him as guard and man from Fall Down Hole.
No, it's more man. John dropped down the hole.
Ben and John from the hole, he fell down the hole first.
Yeah, the drum gave out.
Hole.
In the crevasse.
Yeah, he was getting on our last commute.
So, show us the money. We'll show you the amulet, and then we'll trade.
Really
show
have some trust
me the money.
We have been through a lot.
Reach over.
All of the party scoffs at once, like.
It's been a rough couple of days.
He'll reach over, pull out a sack, and set it on the table.
How much was the agreed price?
Because how much should we agree on?
1,100.
Really?
Yeah.
Let me take some out of here.
No, hold up.
I thought it was 12.
My memory could be faulty.
Well, you remember 11. Must be my memory that's faulty.
No,
no
I don't
no,
think
no,
so.
No, no, no. If you hadn't sent us with such a lousy guard, we would have been done with this a lot quicker. Henry.
Henry. 6.5 days. It's a 3-day trip and a 3-day back.
Yeah, well, we ran. I could have been doing this leisurely. I could be having fucking scones now. The full payment is required.
Yeah, it's 1,100.
Right,
you just told me that.
The orc is also stupid.
He's had some head trauma.
So how much was it?
I'm gonna try intimidation here.
Did anyone write it down?
Oh no, I wrote it down.
Well, then look at what it is.
It's
1,100. Oh.
Me.
No. No. Look, just give us the sack. We brought you the amulet.
Or
give
we
us
can
the,
keep the amulet. I'm sure it'll be helpful to us, yeah.
I have the money.
Yes.
How much is it?
Well, I have 1,500 in the sack.
All right.
There you go. Get to 1,500. Here's your amulet.
All right.
Take the money.
Thank you.
Did he take any out?
None of you guys were arguing, and he's like, whatever. He doesn't have time for
awesome.
All right, let's go back to the inn and divvy this up. I need a bath and a nap.
All right.
Anyone?
Rest.
I'm not going to take the bath with you.
Rest. So you all head back to the inn?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to get some rooms. We're going to meet in a private room, because we're not going to be doling this money out in public.
Okay. All
right.
Kim Kardashian.
Fine.
And then we're going to split up.
If the pixie gets caught in the bath, we know who to blame.
Yeah.
So, you all walk into the inn. All right. I see five of you. How many rooms do you need?
Five.
All right, that'll be about 35 gold.
Each? Total.
Total.
How much for my room?
Seven.
Seven gold each.
I'm going to give him seven.
Same.
All right.
Pay for all the rooms out of the...
No, because that makes it harder to divvy up.
Yeah. Let's talk about evens and odds right now.
If you pay for the rooms outside out of the winnings, and then we divvy it up evenly, we each get $293, and I want an even cut because I saved your ass.
But see, if you could remember that we didn't agree on an even cut at the beginning of this,
and I saved your all's asses,
which is why I'm going to pay you more than the price we agreed upon.
And how much more is that?
An extra 50.
Yeah, I want a fair cut.
You're getting 200.
I want 293.
Well, that's tough, because you should have negotiated more at the beginning.
All right. Come get it.
It's an odd cut. I'll fly over and go get it.
Let's roll some AC, then.
You mean initiative?
Yeah.
Whatever. Attack / combat. AC.
13.
14.
She'll get first move.
Alright, let me pull this up real quick.
Just backhand her and let's get this over with.
I'm going to follow the rules of combat. That's my general plan.
I'm going to laugh. Jay Charles in the game. He's like, oh, here's all the money. All of us are going to be like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
That's why you always have a partner.
So, I tried to warn you the first time.
Stop! No, I'll just kill her this time. Go! I hate fucking licks. Go! 50.
Thus ends the fellowship.
Alright.
How much more health does he need?
Me?
No, you heal him all the way.
No, he's 4 months left.
Pixie, get lost.
Okay.
Wow, that applies for both combat.
We can fight, or you can give me my money, and I'll heal you the rest of the way.
A little rest will take care of that.
Your choice.
Sorry, being healed up a little bit ain't worth 93 gold.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my action. Rhonda's threatening everybody's canutes with her,
her skizzers of...
Nootlessness.
I was trying to think of an office branding.
I am going to go ahead and use Thorn Whip. And I am going to Thorn Whip him. Bring him closer.
Awesome.
take the gold out of his hand, the bag of gold, and hit the floor. Because there's no fucking way she can carry 1,500 coins of fucking gold.
How much can I carry?
At which point, I punt her ass out of the room!
Wingardium Leviosa.
How much does a 1,500 pound bag of gold weigh?
Yeah,
out of curiosity?
Probably 1,500 pounds.
That's because
I'm carrying.
Yeah, how are you carrying?
How
is
anybody
carrying? I worded that wrong. How much is 1,500 gold?
I'm the only one not getting in the weight argument here. I'm completely up for a reaction of Thorn whipping me and bringing me in range.
I was about to say, if you guys want to get into the whole, you know, 7 gold coins, which is the average cost of
a
day living in the city, it's going to quickly get tedious because I'm going to have each of you figure out how much you're carrying, what's
yeah.
your encumbrance. So we just say that
so
money...
So everybody, let's ignore that.
Money weighs nothing.
Cool. Exactly.
I mean, a bag of gold...
We'll be owned on Tuesday.
The bag of whatever.
It's like Hermione's
it's
bag. It
oh.
swallows it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's magical.
Or like Mary Poppins.
Those do exist, by the way.
It's a little
Tuesday, brother.
Is that
28?
Wait,
Thursday.
Dude, I'm
going
GameStop.
I'm going to leave.
We're just
like, what the fuck is it doing out on a Thursday, by the way? I'll see this episode.
It's Skyrim and...
Universe 2.
No, there's another one.
Anyways.
Alright, so I'm going to thorn whip and I'm going to take the gold. I'm going to get really close to his face and go, I am tired. I am dirty. And I will heal you if you give me my gold.
Let's see if your thorn whip hits me.
We can do that. Minor details.
Oh, yeah. Very.
But I know
so
I don't like being played.
Make a melee spell attack.
A melee spell attack.
She will say that currently he is about 10 feet away from me.
Nine.
Doesn't hit his AC.
No.
Okay.
Do you have anything that you would like to do as a bonus action?
Yes.
This is for the... Right? Got a best of 16.
Some pixies fighting, and you didn't put up a fight. You didn't even come originally.
Right.
No, just like not even with the fighting, just for normal price.
You'll get paid. You know,
she
your agreed upon price plus extra
because
okay.
you didn't pull up the entire mission. Like,
yeah. She wants more than I'm going to pay, and that's what the throwdown's about.
I'm not a greedy bitch.
I'm a very greedy orc.
I know you are. If I hadn't healed him, he'd have, like, 4 points, and I could have left his ass in the cave.
Which I was okay with. I'd still get more.
Alright. If we're doing that, I guess I'm doing Moonbeam.
Is a bonus action?
Moonbeam's a bonus?
That's not a bonus.
Yeah, like.
What can I do as a bonus action?
Well, they say bonus action.
Yeah.
If you don't have anything you can do to bonus action, then nothing. Spit on it.
Flip them off, fly away.
Up here, screen daddy.
Alright. I'm going to say, fine. Give me the 300.
Two.
Oh, so now it's gone up again.
He said 3.
No.
No, you
said 293.
Oh, give me the 200.
Well, you just tried to thorn whip me, so I'm going to take a swing first.
Okay.
That's
see if the dice is pretty good. Let's see here. That is 17.
That will not hit.
Oh, she's got 18.
My AC is 18.
Nice. Because
I have that shield.
Oh, yeah.
Bravo.
So, as you come, you take your maul and you just bring it down, and somehow, damn it, this little pixie just raises
right.
a shield and it just, like, glances right off.
Ha! It's impressive.
I'm an impressive little thing. Give me my money.
200.
Fine, I just want a bath.
You don't need money for a bath.
I'll pluck out 200 and give it to you.
Fair enough. Woohoo!
And the innkeeper at this point goes, can you all take this into a room?
I thought we were in a room.
No, no. You just paid this for two rooms.
She wanted us to pay for the rooms out of the
gold.
The reward gold instead of just
plonking. Oh, I thought we had gone into a room.
You guys have two rooms that have been paid for so
yeah.
far.
We have rooms.
Yeah,
none
we paid for mine.
Three rooms.
I was going to say, oh, I thought I had just paid and we'd gone into a room.
No, the whole fight was because...
Oh.
You wanted him to take it out of the room.
I said, okay, I thought that was my consent, sorry.
No, this was right in the middle of the bar.
Yeah, this was a public showdown.
Well, hey, nobody's going to fuck with the pixie now, are they?
It's the worst bar fight of all time.
Right.
Miss.
swing, miss.
I'm tired!
swing, miss, pixie backs down.
So you pay for a room?
Yeah. How much is it? Seven gold?
Seven gold. You're paying for a room? Okay. So everybody keep track that you're spending seven gold on rooms?
Yep. That's pretty good.
Then I assume that you all want to go into a room to divvy out the little rest of the
I'm going to give you each your 200.
I had to fight for my gold because I didn't have much to pay for my room.
Nope. Once we're in there, count at 200 each of you, and then tell you all to get out of my room and give you half of what remains. So that's 450.
You know, I was in jail.
Right.
And actually, before you all can leave, there is going to be a knock at the door.
Is this what was in the kitchen?
You didn't go into the kitchen.
And followed you here.
Why did you?
It's gonna be a knock at my door.
Yep.
Whose door?
Well, currently
we're
you're in his
room.
Room.
Right. I'm gonna
we're trying to get you
pick up my mace, and I'm gonna answer the door.
And standing there will be about a 6.5 foot tall, older gentleman, wearing. What appears to be some kind of golden armor, and he has a sword that the hilt is also made out of gold. He's got white hair just about that range, so a little beyond his shoulder, but it's pulled back into like a ponytail.
So we found King Midas.
He found us. And, well, it looks like gold.
Fair enough.
You can give me a perception check if you'd like to know more.
Not too free, Terry. All right. Greedy bitch.
As it falls in a crevice.
For a boss.
Thank you.
10 plus my perception. That's the 13.
It looks like gold, but at the same time, it almost doesn't look like a metal. It looks like it was grown, almost like a wood, into the shape that it needed.
Human?
Very sleek features, looks closer to elvish, but the eyes aren't correct. And the ears aren't pointed at all either.
But
hey, he could just be a pointy human.
I'm not playing, I'm going into intimidation mode.
I know.
You don't even know what he wants yet.
Doesn't matter.
He looks close to elf, and I have murderous tendencies towards elves and orcs.
Okay, great.
That's why I asked.
Let me pull up the.
What is this doing all the way over here?
I haven't.
It's shut.
I know.
But he just no. He just.
Because I just threw it at him.
Oh.
It's only 14.
Where did I hide those?
for it to pay by the way, that's it. You said 14?
Yep.
How would you like to try to intimidate him?
Just kind of,
What do you want?
Right.
How tall are you again?
Six four.
Five.
Not by much.
Well, no, I was being like,
yeah,
the towering man who can't even see in the door. No, I was like, he's taller than you.
Yeah, the dragon comes up. Come on, Muffin. Back to bed. All
right.
Poor elf man's like, I'm come.
So, how would you like to intimidate him?
Just kind of open the door, you know, seeing on the mace instantly, you know, level with his face. Just a little growl. I suggest you depart from my door before I tear your head off.
Or what do you want?
No, there's no what do you want. It's just get the fuck out.
What if he wants to bring you money?
We don't want money right now.
With a critical one.
I'm so sorry. He's in some beliefs.
My apologies. I was actually looking for, and he'll kind of peek around you and go, those three.
I didn't know
these three?
Those three.
The females. I didn't do it.
No.
We didn't fuck up.
Give me a perception check here.
I don't wanna.
Twelve.
You recognize this person.
Huh.
It is a fey nobleman known as Fira.
Oh!
Oh my god.
I know that person.
She's
Fae, you're dead.
Well, no, she's a Fae Bat Warlock.
President.
I have a Fae President. I love it.
You don't recognize him, but you do recognize that it is a Fae.
Alright. What's that back?
So, my apologies, I did not mean to startle you.
There's no startling about it. I don't like you.
I don't know why.
From the back of the room. It's alright, he doesn't like most people.
Well, everybody take their business then, and get out.
I'll flit over his shoulder and say, see you, Naz, in the sweetest possible voice. Because despite the fact that we just fought, he still likes me.
The illusions of grandeur.
He will support if you want.
It's the pixie way.
Let's find out what he wants.
I'm going to just flit over to him.
Nope.
And ask, may I help you?
There we go. Pixie's taken care of it.
Well, I would like to speak with at least you three in private.
Jesus.
These two can join with.
She goes, I go.
Well, I'm not welcome in your room, so I would not be joining you in your room.
I'll come out.
Okay. Well, I have a room rented. Would you all care to join me in it?
Yes.
Sure, why not?
Guy shows up, still on. Says, I request the presence of the three ladies.
I have a room.
I was going to say, I'm not feeling good about this.
Please, brother.
So, you all enter his room, he will enter first, and leave the door open for you all to follow. I believe that you already know me. Would you care to make introductions?
I suppose this is Firo. He is a fey nobleman.
Wow.
It's not an easy feat. You obviously are unaware of this, but... doesn't matter. So.
Yes, he accepts it.
I would like for you three to accomplish a task that was given to me. He because you all made my task harder. So I'm calling in my favors for each of you.
Ah.
Well, shit.
And what favors do I owe you that you can call them in randomly?
I returned him to you. In the cave. He was going to die in a den, and I returned him back.
Well, is it pissed on your tree?
It wasn't my tree.
Did you say, are you the tree?
You didn't do shit, I pissed on the tree.
It
pissed me.
Peeing on the where the
yeah, is.
And it touched the tree, that's why he thought he fell. Really, Naz, you thought you had magical piss?
I'm awesome.
So what did you do?
You mean what did I do?
How you do that? I will serve you. I have no choice.
I don't know what's happening, so I don't know.
I didn't ask him. You didn't ask him. That's just generosity. Fuck him.
Either way, I still ask you to. I would like it if you would. If not, then we will meet again. And again. And again.
I feel you should be aware that he will take Naz back. He has the power.
Take him back where?
Thank you!
I'm not a dead dude. Do I get any access to this mission?
You're not even here.
I'm in the room.
No!
He came.
Did he cause him to fall?
Yeah.
Just randomly tagged along?
Right? Yeah. I don't know why, but
he
did.
Said he was like, for the ride.
You all caused the mess anyways. Why did you guys have to enter the dragon?
That is an excellent question.
Oh. Is that
I was
going
to say, I don't particularly know why the three of us have to do the dirty work when those two did it. But I know why you call upon me.
I can ask them to do it. It is up to them. But I have been tasked with going and speaking with the dragon and making reparations.
Sucks for you.
And instead, you two will do it for me.
Why? They didn't do anything! Make these fuckers do it!
Can't make me do shit.
Stupid bitches.
Well, I'm all fit enough.
I hate all of these people.
So wait, pause. No, let's pause. He brought Naz back? So, he's the one who threw him in the hole, or he's the one who made sure he didn't die when he fell in the hole?
He's the one that moved the room that allowed it to cave in for me to fall.
Yeah.
But why did you do that?
No, word. This isn't like in game.
Awesome.
I'm just making sure I understand exactly
what's
going on.
No, I don't say it. Why?
Why did he do that?
I'm confused. I don't know what's happening.
So ask your question.
I just
did.
I'm assuming Queen Titania sent you.
Not that high up.
No.
Definitely not.
Royalty.
So,
yes, this bump on that one.
I would like for you guys to go and make reparations to the dragon.
For what?
Pissed it off. You destroyed the natural order.
Dragons are all dragons.
That's why you
were there.
Originally, I wasn't, actually.
Natural order was a chance to make extra gold. I regret nothing.
Yes, but there are greater forces at work.
Ain't no force greater than gold.
So you think.
So I know.
Naz, you do realize that he's going to kill you, right?
He's welcome to try.
Pixie, he almost killed him by throwing him down the hole.
I still don't know what's happening, so I'm just going to be a warrior.
Just tag along with her. She'll make sure that it's taken care of.
No.
That's an awful punishment.
I mean, the other option is I'll just take away all of your powers and you'll be back to being you.
You have a Fey Lord who's telling you if you do not do this, you're no longer going to be a warlock.
But you're not my Fey person.
You're tiefling. You're part of their world.
Yeah.
He's got pull over you.
But
and over her.
Person.
He thought he had pull over me because he tried to kill Naz and said he brought him back.
So we're just laughing at it.
But in reality, I mean, I was going to leave Naz down there anyway. And if I didn't find anybody, then Naz dies. There's only so much I can fucking do.
Word.
It's his fault Naz was as bad as he was. Near the end, anyway.
So in short, go find the dragon. Make the dragon happy.
Why? How?
I don't know. That's for you to figure out.
I don't want to take the job.
Cool.
Find something else to do.
Let's go get something to eat.
Enjoy that.
I will take your mission. I have no choice.
Now, if you all don't mind, I have to be getting back. And he will